This tutorial is part of our practical database design course. You can find a link to the YouTube playlist for this course in the video description. Alternatively, if you like this course, you can watch the complete course uninterrupted, ad-free, access updated tutorials and download the source code and more from our Udemy course. Again, the link to the course is in the video description. So now we've taken a look at the traditional approach, approach one, let's take a look at a second approach that we can use to identify entities. Now, you may undertake both approaches in order to reconfirm the fact that you've found the entities and attributes, but this is a different approach. Now, if you remember, I've mentioned the idea that if we're going to actually create a new table, new entity in our database, then that entity must have attributes, else it's just an empty table and we can't store any data. So when we work on that fact that all entities in our database would typically have attributes, we could work the opposite way of creating entities. We could simply look for a list of attributes or look for attributes, and then we could work with them in a certain way, like you're going to see, in order to identify entities. Now, I'm not suggesting at any point here that this is the way to work. This is the approach to work, and everyone is using this approach. This is just another way of helping you get started identifying entities and attributes. So in the first approach, this is the table and fields that we've generated in that first approach. But what I'm going to do here is, let's imagine we only generated the attributes. So we're going to take these attributes and we're going to then just work with them slightly differently. So we're going to name them slightly differently. What we're going to do, we're going to name these attributes associated to the entity or to the thing that they are associated to. So whatever attribute they're associated to. So the content is the post content. This is going to be the post image and so on. But what we're going to do here is just think a little bit more specific. So for example, the image isn't necessarily the image. We're not storing data about the image, are we? We're storing something very specific about the image. So we need to take that into consideration. So let's make the assumption that these don't exist, but we're using for now so that we can create this preliminary attribute list. So we're making the assumption that maybe it's much easier to find attributes. You know that there are certain attributes that you're going to need to create, but you're not too sure what entities you're going to need to build. So let's start with content. So we're going to say, for example, post content. So we know that the content is part of the post happy days, right? Image. So post image. So it could be a post image, but I think we need to be more specific. What data is exactly going to be stored here? So if I said to you, what data is going to be stored in this field, which will be a field, right? What will be the answer? Well, we don't know, because an image, well, that could be many different things. So we need to be more specific here, which means us actually identifying an attribute of the image. So maybe it's an image URL. Remember, the URL is the location where the image is stored. So we would give that back to the software. The software would then be able to tell the browser, if it's a browser-based application, where to find the image, and then it can show the image. So that's more specific. So we might have that information. And when we're working this way, we can now start to think, well, actually, there might be more information we need to store about the image. Maybe we need to store, for example, the image name, for example. I don't think that really is a thing, though, that we probably need to store information about. But you get the general idea. I won't actually include that because that's not really something that we need to store information about. So let's go for a name alternative text. So if you're familiar to web development, for example, you'll know that in order to correctly display an image, we should have alternative text, and that allows and creates accessibility features so that maybe someone who's partially sighted or when an image cannot be shown, there is some text potentially so we can identify what image is being displayed. So alternative text, we want to associate that to an image. So we want to store that data in a database so it can be passed to the application. Right, so we've got that information. So date created. So post date created. Okay, so I think that's very clear. That's when the post was created. So we've got status. So I think we can probably say post status. Okay, so what's the post status? Blah, blah, blah. Okay, that's specific information. And then we had the category name. Okay. So now we've got the category name. It's weird. I'm having this kind of deja vu moment where I've had this dream where I've done this before. Very strange. Come on. Okay. Right. So now we have some more very specific fields or attributes. So what you can see straight away and what we're leading towards here is this idea of being very specific with the attributes here. We can identify potentially the entities that this attribute is associated to. So here we've got a post. If we were to organize this now, we've got post, we've got images, and we've got category. So by working this way, in actual fact, we're actually removing the need for many different processes in this design process that we're going to learn about, because we've identified attributes and their entities potentially by just thinking more specifically about the actual attributes. So now potentially I have three, we've not done the user yet, but potentially here we have three tables, three entities that we're going to need to build. And then we can do the same with the user. So I'll quickly do that. So user, username, doesn't really make sense, but you get the idea, user, username, and so on. I don't think there's anything here. I think everything is good here. User password, user type, user first name and last name. So there isn't too much here. I won't finish that off because we want to put this into a table. So hopefully you get the idea there. We've identified potentially now four tables. So in actual fact, I'll quickly build these. So I'm not suggesting this will always be an approach that will work for your particular scenario or use case, but it is definitely something to consider. Throughout this design process, I will use multiple sets of tables and attributes related to the blog simply to showcase different approaches and methods of working through each of the design phases. So we will go forward, we will move forward with both this approach and the two tables that we demonstrated before, because then I'll be able to show you the stages in more detail and how you can apply that to this actual project. Although I will provide you some different examples of working through the design process.